Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Sandra Jones. Science and spacewalk preparations kept the crew aboard the International Space Station busy this week. On Monday, NASA astronauts Tracy Dyson and Mike Barrett will exit the station's Quest airlock to complete the removal of a faulty electronics box called a radio frequency group from a communications antenna on the starboard truss of the space station. The pair also will collect samples for analysis to understand the ability of microorganisms to survive and reproduce on the exterior of the orbiting laboratory. Dyson will serve as Spacewalk Crew Member 1 and will wear a suit with red stripes. Barrett will serve as Spacewalk Crew Member 2 and will wear an unmarked spacesuit. US Spacewalk 90 will be the fourth spacewalk for Dyson and the first for Barrett. A second spacewalk to remove and replace a gyroscope assembly, relocate an antenna, and prepare for future alpha magnetic spectrometer upgrades is scheduled for Tuesday, July 2nd. Following the completion of the first spacewalk, NASA will announce participating crew members and provide additional coverage details for US Spacewalk 91. You can watch the spacewalk live on NASA Television, NASA Plus, the NASA app, YouTube, and the agency's website. Back inside the space station, science continues aboard the orbiting lab. NASA astronaut and pilot of the recently arrived NASA's Boeing Starliner spacecraft, Sonny Williams, worked on the solid fuel ignition and extinction material ignition and suppression test, also known as SOFI MIST. This investigation examines thermally assisted burning in microgravity by varying parameters, including airflow speed, oxygen concentration, pressure, and level of external radiation. Results could improve understanding of early fire growth behavior and validate models for material flammability, helping to inform selection of safer materials for future space facilities and determine the best methods for extinguishing fires in space. Just like on Earth, it's important to know what supplies you have available, and one NASA astronaut stepped through inventory procedures to do just that. NASA astronaut and commander of NASA's Boeing Starliner spacecraft, Butch Wilmore, conducted inventory of the Human Research Facility 2, or HRF-2. The facility provides an on-orbit laboratory that enables human life science researchers to study and evaluate the psychological, behavioral, and chemical changes induced by spaceflight. Research performed using HRF-2 provides data to help scientists understand how the human body adapts to long-duration spaceflight. NASA and Boeing are now targeting no earlier than June 26th for the landing of the Starliner spacecraft. To continue to follow along with the Starliner mission and its latest updates, be sure to check out nasa.gov and the space station blog. But for now, that's Space to Ground for this week. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time.